Hello, everyone, and welcome to Coffee House 2021.
We're so excited to be your host again.
Even though this is a little different, we still wanted to show you guys all the amazing performances.
So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
To start off, I wanted to give Marcus the opportunity to redeem himself from the open mic dancing fiasco.
Not again.
And a 5, 6, 7, 8.
Woo-wee.
It's getting there.
Well, I didn't want to upstage anyone with my amazing dancing skills.
Oh, that makes sense.
Well, anyways, our first performance will be from the Vancouver Speak Performances.
Please give a round of applause to Gemma, Julia, Noah, Carson, Finley, and Sihi.
Hello, I wish to register a complaint. Hello, miss.
What do you mean, miss?
I'm sorry, I have a cold. I wish to register a complaint.
We're closing for lunch.
Never mind that, my lad. I wish to complain about this parrot, which I purchased not half an hour ago from this very boutique.
Ah, yes, the Norwegian Blue. What's wrong with it?
I'll tell you what's wrong with it. He's dead, that's what's wrong with it.
No, now he's resting.
Look, mate, I know a dead parrot when I see one, and I'm looking right at one.
No, he's resting. Remarkable bird, isn't he, the Norwegian Blue? Lovely plumage.
All right, then, if he's resting, I'll wake him up. Hello, Mr. Polar Parrot. I've got a lovely fresh cuttlefish for you, if you show.
There, you moved.
No, he did. That was you hitting the cage.
I never.
Yes, you did.
I never did anything.
Hello, Polly. Testing. This is your 9 o'clock alarm. Now, that's what I call a dead parrot.
No, he's stunned.
Stunned?
Yeah, you stunned him just as he was waking up. Norwegian Blue stunned very easily.
Look, mate, I've had enough of this. When I bought this parrot, you assured me that its total lack of movement was due to being tired and shagged out, following a prolonged squawk.
Well, he's probably pining for the fjords.
Pining for the fjords? What kind of talk is that? Look, why did he fall flat on his back the moment I got home?
The Norwegian Blue prefers keeping on his back. Lovely bird, isn't he?
Look,
plumage.
Look, I took the liberty of examining this parrot when I got home. And I discovered that the only reason he'd been sitting on his perch in the first place is that it'd been nailed there.
Well, of course it'd been nailed there. If I hadn't nailed him there, he would have nuzzled up to those bars, bent them apart with his beak, and boom!
Boom? Mate, this bird wouldn't boom through 4 million balls through it. He's stone dead.
No, he's pining.
He's not pining, he's passed on. This parrot has ceased to be. He's expired and gone to meet his maker. He's a stiff. He's snuffed it. This is an ex-parrot.
Well, I'd better replace it then. Sorry, Squaw, I've had a look round the back of the shop and we're right out of parrots.
I see, I get the picture.
I've got a slug.
Parade is a talk.
No.
Well, it's hardly a replacement then, isn't it?
Well, I never wanted to do this in the first place. I wanted to be a lumberjack.
The Telephone Call by Fleur Adcock. They asked me, are you sitting down? Right. This is Universal Lotteries, they said. You've won the top prize, the Ultra Super Global Special. What would you do with £1 million? Or, actually, with more than £1 million. Not that it makes a lot of difference once you're a millionaire. And they laughed. Are you okay? They asked. Still there? Come on now, tell us. How does it feel? I said, I can't believe it. They said, that's what they all say. Go on now, tell us about it. I said, I feel the top of my head has floated off, out through the window, revolving like a flying saucer. That's unusual, they said. Go on. I said, I'm finding it hard to talk. My throat's gone dry, my nose is tingling. I think I'm gonna sneeze or cry. That's right, they said. Don't be ashamed of giving way to your emotions. It isn't every day you hear you're going to get £1 million. Relax now. Have a little cry. We'll give you a moment. Hang on, I said. I haven't bought a lottery ticket for years and years. And what did you say the company was called again? They laughed. Again. Not to worry about a ticket. We're Universal. We operate on a retrospective chances module. Nearly everyone's bought a ticket in some lottery or another. Once at least. We buy up the files, feed the names into our computer, and see who the lucky person is. Well, that's incredible, I said. It's marvelous. I still can't quite. I'll believe it when I see the check. Oh, they said. There's no check. But the money? We don't deal in money. Experiences are what we deal in. You've had a great experience, right? Exciting. Something you'll remember. That's your prize. So congratulations from all of us at Universal. Have a nice day. And the line went dead.
There was a moment of complete silence. Then the little prince flashed back at me with a sense of resentfulness.
I don't believe you. Flowers are weak creatures. They are naive. They reassure themselves best they can. They believe that their thorns are terrible weapons.
I did not answer.
At that instant, I was saying to myself, if this bolt still won't turn, I'm going to knock it out with my hammer.
Again, the little prince disturbed my thoughts.
And you actually think that the flowers?
Oh no, I cried.
No, no, no. I don't believe in anything. I answered you with the first thing that came into my head. Don't you see? I am very busy with matters of consequence.
He stared at me, thunderstruck.
Matters of consequence?
He looked at me there, with my hammer in my hand, my fingers black with engine grease, bending down over an object which to him seemed extremely ugly.
You talk just like the grown-ups.
That made me a little ashamed. But he went on, relentlessly.
You mix up everything together. You confuse everything.
He was really very angry. He tossed his golden curls in the breeze.
I know a planet where there's a certain red-faced gentleman. He has never smelled a flower. He has never looked at a star. He has never loved anyone. He has never done anything in his life but add up figures. And all day, over and over, he says, just like you, I am very busy with matters of consequence. And that makes him swell up with pride. But he is not a man, he is a mushroom.
A what?
A mushroom!
The little prince was now white with rage.
The flowers have been growing thorns for millions of years. And for millions of years, the sheep's been eating them just the same. And is it not a matter of consequence to try to understand why the flower go to so much trouble to grow thorns, of which are never of any use to them? And is the warfare between the sheep and the flower not important? Is this not more of a consequence than some fat, red-faced gentleman's sums? And if I know, I, myself, one flower, which is unique in the world, which grows nowhere but on my planet, of which one little sheep can destroy in a single bite some morning without even noticing what he's doing. Oh, and you think that's not important?
His face turned from white to red. As he continued,
if someone loves a flower, of which one single blossom grows in the millions and millions of stars, it is enough to make him happy just to look at the stars.
He can say to himself, somewhere, my flower is here.
But if the sheep eats the flower, then in one moment, all of his stars will be darkened. And you think that's not important?
Not say anything more. His His words were choked by sobbing. The night had fallen. I had let my tools drop from my hands. But what moment now was my fault, my hammer, thirst, or death? On one planet, my planet, the Earth, there was a little prince to be comforted. I took him in my arms and rocked him. I said, "The flower that you love is not in danger. I will draw a muzzle for your sheep. I will put a fence around your flower. I will..." I did not know what to say. I felt awkward and blundering. I did not know how I could overtake him and go on hand in hand with him once more. It is such a secret place, the land of tears.
I'm really sorry, Annie.
It was just not fair. Do you hear me?
Annie, it wasn't you, really.
I'll never know now if it was me. If I hurt you.
Oh no, Annie, you were the best thing that ever happened to me. You were.
So why can't you tell me?
I can tell you this much. Annie, can you hear me? It wasn't you.
I know it was me. It was always me.
Oh no, Annie, it wasn't. I love you. I loved you. And I'll always love you.
You are no angel, Tommy.
Tell me about it.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Hey, stop apologizing. I'm not worth it.
See, even now I hurt you. You never thought much about yourself. And when I called you names, you must have been really hurt.
I was, but I deserved it, Annie.
You'd always say, "But I deserved it, Annie." I miss you, Tommy. Do you know that?
I do now. Yes, I do now.
No matter how much we fought or called each other names, I still miss you. And you didn't even say goodbye. People who love each other shouldn't do that.
I know.
You should have told me something was wrong. I would have never left you. I loved you.
I loved you too, Annie. And please don't be sad.
Everyone keeps saying, "Annie, please don't be sad."
I'm not worth it, Annie.
He's not worth it, Annie.
Annie, please, Annie.
Annie. What do they know? What did anyone know? How could they possibly know how I feel? You broke my heart. I know it was me.
No, it wasn't you.
Yeah.
No, Annie, can't you understand? It wasn't you. I loved you.
I tell you how much I loved you, but it's too late now. You're gone forever.
No, Annie, look, I'm right here, right beside you, right on this bench.
I can only feel your arms around me.
Annie, I love you.
What's that icy chill?
Chill?
I must be getting a cold.
A chill? For me? Annie, I love you.
I tell you that I loved you, but it's too late now. I'll never know why you did it.
Neither will I.
It was so sudden.
It was a dumb, stupid mistake. I was just down over so many things. And it seemed like there was nothing left.
You could have got help. Everyone can.
I know that now.
I know you could have worked this out. Together we could have. guess for as long as I live. I'll always blame myself for what happened.
Oh no, Annie, please, please don't believe that. I'll never be able to rest in peace if you think that.
Look at all these weeds. These are for you, Tommy. Daisies.
Annie, I love you.
I'm sorry if I hurt you. And I'm sorry if I can't come to see you anymore.
What? No.
It's been a year now. A whole new summer is here. It's beautiful. I wish we could enjoy it together. And I wish I could be with you. But my doctor says it's not healthy to dwell on the past. So, Tommy, I've come for the last time.
No, Annie, please.
I just had to come here one last time.
No, please don't go.
I had to come here just one more time to say goodbye to you, my dear, sweet friend, Tommy.
No, Annie, please. Annie, please don't go. Annie, I love you. Annie, please.
I have to go. Goodbye, Tommy.
Please don't go. Don't leave me, Annie. Annie, please. Annie, don't leave me alone.
Wow, those were amazing.
I can see an Oscar in all of your futures.
All right then, on with the show. But before that, I want to get my revenge on Lily for making me dance so much.
I don't like where this is headed.
Well, it's only fair. Besides, our next performances will be by the strings, so why don't you give us a little musical performance?
Okay. I thought that was pretty good.
Alright.
Well, anyways, to wash away that kind of embarrassing display, up next is the octet featuring Aiden, Kiara, Sophia, Cynthia, Adrian, Andrew, and Mrs. Goddard. And they will be playing Octet Number 20 by Mendelssohn.
And after that, we'll have a quintet featuring Jason, Chloe, Mallory, Jack, and Miss Lemon. And they'll be playing the Trout, Variations 3 and 4 by Schubert. And also a welcome from the VSO.
Happy Arts Week, West Point Grey Academy. I'm Otto Tausk, Music Director of the Vancouver Symphony Orchestra. To me, the arts, and especially music, means expressing ourselves in connection with others, exchanging our thoughts, our feelings, and hopes through music and the arts. Maybe the most valuable and precious gift we have. Enjoy the Arts Week.
Thank you.
year has been hard for all of us.
It's been weird for sure.
Wearing masks every day.
Not being able to see friends.
I've been almost losing it.
I think most of us have.
But we have all rose up to the challenge this year.
And performing the song Rise Up, here is Mia and Olivia.
Broken down and tired of living life on a merry-go-round, and you can't find the fighter, but I see it in you. So we're gonna walk it out and move mountains. Gonna walk it out and move mountains, and I'll rise up, I'll rise like the day, and I'll rise up, I'll rise unafraid, I'll rise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again. And I'll rise up high like the waves, and I'll rise up in spite of the ache. I'll rise up and I'll do it a thousand times again.
Knock knock.
Who's there?
Art.
R2.
R2-D2.
Actually, I kind of like that one. But I don't get how that segues into the next performance.
Art, drawing, ear, listening, music.
You lost me.
Here, drawing to music, performed by Natasha, is Ren. Planet, and the first name has the word Uno in it. Bruno Mars!
Yeah.
Nice. Okay, guess the song. Do all the things I should have done when...
That's a song!
Here to show Marcus and the rest of you this Bruno Mars song, here is Michelle singing When I Was Your Man.
That I should have bought you flowers and took a strong woman like you to walk out my life.
Jokes?
What did one poem say to the other poem?
I don't know.
Neither do I.
Oh, just go with it.
Okay, sorry, I'm lost. What did one poem say to the other poem? Oh, no, neither do I. Just go with it. The other poem said, "You are a great poem."
Okay. Well, here with her poetry reading, here's Reindeer. That was really bad.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I panicked!
You begin this way. This is your hand, this is your eye. This is a fish, born flat on the table, almost the shape of an eye. This is your mouth, this is an O, or a moon, whichever you like. This is yellow. Outside the window is the rain, green because it's summer, and beyond that the trees, and then the world, which is round, and has only the colors of these 9 crayons. This is a world which is fuller and more difficult to learn than I have said. You are right to smudge it that way, the red and then the orange. The world burns. Once you have learned these words, you'll learn that there are more words than you can ever learn. The word hand floats above your hand like a small cloud over a lake. The word hand anchors your hand to this table. Your hand is a warm stone I hold between 2 words. This is your hand. These are my hands. This is a world that is round but not flat and has more colors than we can see. It begins, it has an end. This is what you will come back to. This is your hand.
Thank you so much for watching.
Can we have another round of applause for all of our amazing performers?
And on that note, we conclude this year's Coffee House.
Bye, everyone.
Marcus dances.